Crystal Master. Gentlemen and ladies, I present the Crystal Master to be installed, Mark Zeman. Senior Warden to be installed, Randy Paul. Junior Warden to be installed, Arthur Vanderbilt. The Treasurer to be installed. Brad Rosenthal. Secretary to be installed, Ronald G. Wright.
He's always right, by the way.
The Chaplain to be installed. Shogun Judo. The Senior Deacon to be installed, Jeff Sintel. The Junior Deacon to be installed, Michael 23 Jordan. The Steward to be installed, Adam Lamar. The Marshal to be installed, Travis Dunn. Master of Ceremonies to be installed, Luca Menendez. The Tyler to be installed, Austin Hibb. Case none of you know, my name is John Burke. Worship Master, I present the officers elected and appointed for Austin Lodge number 12 to be installed. I believe each of them to be well qualified to discharge the duties of their office. And each has signified his willingness to accept the same. I therefore ask that they be duly and constitutionally installed in their respective offices.
For the Marshal who presents the Worshipful Master election installation, the remaining officers may be seated. Sir and brother, I take pleasure in installing you into this honorable office with the usual ceremony, but it is being invested in the insignia of your office. It is necessary that you should signify your assent to those ancient charges and regulations which point out duty for master of the office. You agree to be a good man true, a stripper to obey the moral law. You agree to be a peaceful citizen, cheerfully to perform the laws of the country to which you reside. You promise not to be censored in plots and conspiracies against government, and patiently submit to the decisions of the Supreme Legislature. You agree to pay proper respect to the civil magistrate, to work diligently, to live credibly, to act honorably by all men. You agree to hold in veneration the original rules and patrons of the Order of Masonry and their regular successors. Supreme and subordinate, according to the station, and submit to the awards and resolutions of your brethren, but convene in every case consistent with the constitutions of the order. You agree to avoid private peace and quarrel and guard against intemperance and excess. You agree to be cautious in carrying the behavior, courteous to your brethren, and faithful to your life. You promise to respect the genuine brethren and to this conflict if possible. In all senses, the original plan of nation. You agree to promote the general good of society, cultivate the social virtues, and propagate the knowledge of the art. You promise to pay homage to the Grand Master, the time being, and his officers, and duly installed, and should be performed at every meeting of the Grand Lodge or General Assembly of the Nation. That is not subversive of the principle of the groundwork of nation. You promise a regular attendance on committees and communications of the Grand Lodge. Receive proper notice and pay attention to all duties of masonry at the meeting occasions. You admit that no new lodge shall be formed without permission of the Grand Lodge, and that no countenance is given to any irregular lodge, or to any person clandestinely initiated therein, being contrary to ancient charges of the order. You admit that no person can be regularly made a mason in or admitted a member of any regular lodge without previous notice and due inquiry into his character. You agree that no visitor shall be received into your lodge without due examination and producing proper vouchers to have been initiated the regular law. These are the regulations between the sections. You submit to these charges and promise to support these regulations as masters have done to all ages before you.
I do.
Brother Venus, the consequence of your cheerful performing the charges and regulations of the order, you are now to be installed as master of this law. Full confidence. Care, skill, and capacity to govern the same. Brother Marshall, you are the best and most powerful master of the city of his office, which is to swear. Various instruments of profession are emblematical of our conduct in life, and upon this occasion are carefully enumerated. The holy writings. That great light in me will guide you to all truth, will direct your path to temple happiness, point out to you the whole duty. Man. Swear. Teaches us to regulate our actions by rule and law and to harmonize our conduct by the principle of immorality and virtue. Compasses. Teach us to limit our desires in every stage of death, rising to the end by merit. Live respectfully, I have read. Rule. Directs that we shall humbly observe our duty, press forward in the path of virtue, and we are inclining to right and work to the left in all our actions, have eternity in view. The line teaches us the criterion of moral ethics. To avoid dissemination of conversation and action and direct our steps to the path which leads to immortality. Book of Constitutions. You are to search at all times, cause to be read in your lodge, that none may pretend to ignorance of the excellent precept to enjoy. Now receive in charge, charter. by the authority of which this law is held, you are carefully preserved and duly transferred it to your successor in office. Lastly, you receive in charge bylaws of your life, which you are to see carefully and punctually executed. Brother Marshall, you will see the wonderful master present the senior warden. Select for his place. Descended from the same stock, partake of the same nature, share the same hope. And though distinctions among men are necessary to preserve subordination, yet no imminent station should make us forget that we are brethren. For he who is placed on the low spoke of fortune's wheel may be entitled to honor God, because I will come. And the wisest know not how soon. All distinction, the that of goodness shall cease, and death, the grand level of human greatness, reduce us to the same state. The regular attendance of state meetings is essentially necessary. In the absence of the master, you are the governor of life. In his presence, you are assisted in the government of life, and firmly rely on your knowledge, the attachment to the law. Faithful discharge of the duty of this important trust. Look well to the west. Brother Marshall, you'll see the super warden sent to Julie for an electoral collection.
You are giving me the jewel.
Yes, thank you. Brother Vanderbilt, Plum admonishes us to walk upright in our several stations, to hold the scale of justice we need to form, to preserve the just medium between temperance and pleasure, and to make our passions and prejudice coincide with the line of our duty. To you is committed the superintendent of the craft during the hours of refreshment. It is therefore indispensably necessary that you should not only be temperate and discreet in the indulgence of your own inclinations, but carefully observe that none of the craft be suffered to convert the means of refreshment into temperance and excess. Brother Marshall will receive the junior award as the treasurer. His office is cross key.
brother, it is your duty to receive all monies from secretary, make due entry thereof, hand them out in order of the wonderful man, and consent of the lot. I trust your regard for the welfare of the court will prompt you in the faithful discharge of your duty. Brother Marshall, you will see the treasurer present the secretary elect. Brother Marshall, you will be the secretary with the same opinion of his father, which is Quill. Brother Wright, it is your duty to carefully observe all of the proceedings of the lodge and this correct record of all things proper to be written. Receive all money to the lodge and hand them over to the treasurer and intercede for the same. I trust your good wishes for the welfare of this lodge and prompt you to discharge duties of your office with fidelity. By doing so, you will merit the esteem and applause of the brethren. Brother Marshall will seat the secretary and present the chaplain for information. Duty to perform the solemn services which we should constantly render to our Creator, which were offered by one of the examples that point to heaven and lead the way, okay, by finding our soul, strengthening our virtues, and purifying our mind, prepare us for admission into the society of those above, the happiness of being endless and to be eternal. Brother Marshall will see the chaplain. Senior and junior deacons for this worship. Sintel Andrew, it is your father. set act as their proxy in active duties of the office, such as the reception of candidates in different degrees to make the introduction and accommodation of the business, and the immediate practice of our rights. Square encompasses the badge of your office. I entrust you with care, not doubting your vigilance and attention. Brother Marshall, you will seat the deacons and present the senior and junior steward. Check that senior steward regulation. Of his office, which is cornucopia or cornucopia.
This is the cornucopia.
This is the cornucopia.
Brother Lamar, Master of Ceremony. Master of ceremony is your duty to assist the deacon and other officers who are expected to see that the table are properly charged and refreshing and reverent suitably provided for. Your regular and early attendance will afford that proof to your deal and attention to the law. For the marshal, you will seek the steward and present the marshal and master of ceremony for his service. It's your duty to assist the senior deacon preparing candidates for initiation and see the needs of the candidate are provided, such as a candidate information program, ritualistic instruction, assigned education, and information concerning customs and usages of nations. Brother Marshall, we will speak to the marshal and master of ceremony and present.
Thank you.
When Marshall was just a pilot, he was sitting in his office. He did the sword. Brother Head, I present you with the instrument of your office. That sword is placed in the hands of the pilot to enable him to guard against the crook talent he is on. He fits none past the toe of the wall. So it should admonish us to set the guard over our cross. Watch our lips. Poke the sentinel over our action, thereby preventing the approach every unworthy thought and deed, thus preserving conscience's void for God and man. Brother Marshall, you will seek the Tyler to prevent the worshipful master from charge. Worshipful sir and brother, to your care is committed the charter of this life, and the government of the brethren composed the same, and are within the jurisdiction of said life. It cannot be the sentence of the obligation to devolve on you at their hand, nor your responsibility to faithful discharge the important duties annexed to said station. Honor, reputation, and usefulness of your life materially depend on the skill with which you manage your concerns, while the happiness of its members will be generally promoted in proportion to the zeal and ability with which you propagate the genuine principles of our institution. For a pattern of imitation, consider the great blue